ocean hides the path to Valravn. Don't trust your eyes. Find another way to see the truth.
Behind the veil, don't we? Once we do, we mostly just close our eyes again and pretend what we saw was never really there.
Comes from ravens. Align the ravens to break his magic seal.
Show me what you have seen, Truth.
Look how much it's changed.
the seal, align the ravens with the mark of Valravn.
Same.
she journeyed into the wilds of her native land, living off of berries, roots, and rabbits. It's not uncommon, you see. We call such a person a gelt. Some, like Truth, become gelt in search of penance. Others, like Sarah, to purge a curse. Those who make it back are forever changed.
She can get up now.
She can get up now. What's happening?
She can get up now.
Can she get up? It
must be
magic.
Dark
magic.
A trick.
Valravn.
Tricking her.
Valravn.
How can she get up?
Bait.
It's him.
Dark magic draws her closer.
It's not... He's helping her. It's not him.
It's a trick.
She's doing it on her own. He's not tricking her. It's magic.
It's an illusion.
Ymir was a frost giant, a being of darkness. And all his sons and grandsons were dark after him. Of his daughters and granddaughters, some were monstrous, but others fair. But there was another who came from the ice. Buri. In shape, he was like a man, big and calm.
Do you know what it's like to leave everything behind? Your home? Loved ones? To head deep into the wilds? Perhaps never to return? Senua does. Because when darkness speaks, it changes everything. Turning home into a foreign land and loved ones into strangers. Exile makes sense when you realize that you were never really home in the first place.
She could beat her own darkness.
Did she beat her darkness?
No. It nearly killed her, but she tried.
Druth. Druth helped her.
If it wasn't for Druth, she'd be dead.
She can't beat her own darkness. She wanted to marry Dillion. She came to beat her own darkness and marry Dillion.
But she didn't thought. Work. She thought her curse would affect him.
She thought her curse would spread to him. She thought she'd bring the darkness to him too. She nearly died.
She thought the curse made her tainted.
Druth helped her.
Not from this.
The Northmen say that Odin and his brothers killed Ymir, and that the world of men was formed from his corpse. They made his bones into stone, and his flesh into earth, and his blood into the salt sea. They set his skull to be the bowl of the sky, with his brains for clouds. Odin and his brothers caught the sparks flying from Muspel and made them into stars. And to protect the new world from the giants, they used Ymir's great curving eyebrows as walls. Northmen say that Odin and his brothers killed Ymir, and that the world of men was formed from his corpse. They made his bones into stone, and his flesh into earth, and his blood into the salt sea. They set his skull to be the bowl of the sky, with his brains for clouds. Odin and his brothers caught the sparks flying from Muspel and made them into stars. And to protect the new world from the giants, they used Ymir's great curving eyebrows as walls.
Ravens.
They've all gone.
No.
There's still three.
There's three.
There's three.
Where have they gone?
Where have they gone?
She did it. What does it mean?
Looking back, it was so naive to think she could banish it on her own. The further she saw into the darkness, the more she struggled to see anything at all. And the glow. The smallest hints of shape, sound, or thought. Grew in strength until they consumed her whole. Before she knew it, the darkness had her in its claws. There's no such thing as victory when it comes to the darkness. It's like it doesn't want to kill her. Yet, it will gnaw at her, biding its time. Only when she is at her weakest will it strike to kill. Will she find Dillion before her time comes?